Hello and welcome, this is Carlos Bostrian, Corvus Belli HQ and Corvus Belli Brand Ambassador, and this is the Corvus Belli official video for supporting Colder than Carbonite in Alberta, Canada, the Canadian event, the Canadian satellite tournament organized by Matt Chaffee, I don't know how to pronounce it, sorry, I would love to be there. In fact, we have to discuss about going some of these years, okay? Because I would love to visit Canada, really. I mean, I have a map and I'm just covering all the possible parts of that beautiful country, okay? So, as I said, this is the Corvus Belli video for supporting a satellite tournament here. We still have some previews, okay? I guess that this is happening, this video is being published during mid-February, I guess, okay? We will see the February releases that will hit the store so soon, and some things that will go even beyond that. I have some questions from you, and we will answer them in the most unsatisfactory and vague way possible, okay? I would love to be there, but this is the best way this company can support your event, okay? Sending previews and sending stuff, okay? So get ready, because you will see at Infinity like the best thing ever happening to you since you have watched this video. My English is a bit thick, you know, but we will make it better. We will make it better. Put some subtitles here or something. So, 2019 has just begun, and we have a lot of things to say, a lot of things to communicate. Corvus Belli right now is working as hard as a Spaniard can work, which is to an American is not so hard, you know. But we have lots of stuff in our chamber, in our secret department, which is currently in development, but it's going to be awesome, believe me. So let's take a look at the 2019 schedule. Okay, that blue N at the beginning of the schedule means the Invincible Army, which maybe you already have the miniatures, okay, but you know it was planned to be released at the beginning of the year. Now we are working very hard in being able to deliver. Attention here, Corvus Belli is going to deliver 5 totally super new and super improved armies for 2019, okay? This could mean an old army that has been totally redesigned, okay? Or a totally new army, or a totally brand new unexpected army, okay? Many of those things will happen, okay? Make your rumors and your bets about which armies are these going to be, but some of them are pretty obvious, and some of them you won't then see them coming. It was totally going to hit you in your face. Okay, just like what happened with Bear and Drew's back in the ending of 2017. Then someday unlock a new army, suddenly, unexpectedly. That will happen again in 2019, okay? So, boom, 5 armies, okay, maybe even more. So, apart from that, I would like to communicate that the structure of the year, which is a bit similar to the structure of 2018, okay, get ready, because for Adepticon, we are planning a big operation, fingers crossed, in order to make it happen properly, okay, but we are planning to make a big plot twist for Infinity, something incredible that is going to change the fluff and make the whole timeline evolve, okay? And also bringing a lovely box with lovely miniatures. It's still a secret. We are waiting to drop the bomb in the appropriate moment, but we are working on it, okay, right now. And a book, okay, another book. A book that will end the trilogy that began with Uprising, then Third Offensive, and then the final book for that kind of whole evolution of the timeline of Infinity, okay? And that book is obviously what unlocks the 5 new armies. That is just the operation for the first third of the year, okay? Then, of course, during 2019, we will focus on making the most incredible bomb of energy to be exploding at Gen Con in August, which is kind of what we have been doing the last years, okay? And that requires all from us, okay? And we will make it. We are ready for that. It's going to take a lot of work because it has to be super awesome. But we have already made some decisions that I think are pretty nice. And then from the last third of the year, the super secret project, the super secret bomb, that is going to require so much from us. It's going to be so much work. But we think we believe in that project. We think it's going to be awesome. And we like to keep that being a super mystery until the right moment. So yeah. three big bombs during the year. Expect a bit like that to be Corvus Belli, apart from the monthly releases, which are lovely. Talking about monthly releases, let's talk about the February news, because during mid-February, maybe some of you are watching this video right in mid-February, these miniatures are going to arrive to your local store, or you can buy it online, or the Corvus Belli online store, which is so cool. Okay, first of all, Kawarichi. Okay, Kawarichi. I have here right here, it's a coincidence totally, the Kawarichi, the Red Turban from the Red Veil Battle Pack, which is a lovely box. Okay, now we are releasing the SWC box full of Kawarichi. Okay, and if you look at them, you will notice that they have some pretty new weaponry. Okay, what does this mean? If you can read among the lines, okay, you will notice that this means that Ramatas Force is obviously coming, and this is the way the Kawarichi are going to be in Ramatas Force. They will be able to assemble fire teams, and they will obviously can make a fire team with Tari Mansuri, which is no big deal, because Tari Mansuri can do all everything that he wants in Ramatas Force. You will see that in the future, okay? Echo Bravo, the first miniature of the Echo Bravo for the Varuna Immediate Reaction Division, okay? For that super pano army that is being tough and popular. I think that everybody likes Varuna. I think their look... I just seen the Varuna tray just seconds ago with all the new Varuna miniatures. That looks lovely. I mean, it's a great moment to begin that army, in my opinion, okay? If you like pano. If you're into pano, you know. The Echo Bravo comes with the Wild Parrot next to him, one of those crazy things that works as a perimeter weapon, okay? The Wild Parrot, yeah. We have Crazy Koalas, Mad Traps, Wild Parrots, what else? Fast Pandas. We have plenty of tiny creatures, silhouette, whatever. Okay, next, Dao Jing Operative Unit from the Yu Qing Invincibles. Yu Qing Invincibles are here, and during this year they're going to have awesome releases, so you will get sick of seeing those orange armors everywhere, okay, during all the tournaments and all the monthly releases, and you will see Invincibles are here. What we have here is the Hacker Option with Boarding Shotgun of the Dao Jing, lovely miniature. Female armor design with blue in the hair color scheme. I'm totally against blue in Yu Qing color schemes because it smells like pano, you know. We have Raoul Spector, the character, mercenary character for the Tunguska Jurisdictional Command. An Omar release, okay, but he's not wearing red. Why? Because he's a mercenary, okay. And finally, Jadu Troopers SWC box, so you can make lovely fire teams of the Jadus for Aleph, for the operation subsection of Aleph. They look lovely, they perform lovely, and they are one of the most powerful sectoral armies ever released from Corvus Belli, because you know that you can make some nasty things with these miniatures in that nasty Aleph sectoral army. So Nomads, you have the greatest enemy possible going to you, okay, going towards you, charging against you. But, well, Operations is not so much about charging, that is more the Steel Phalanx. Operations is just to sit on a tower and shoot. So this has been the February releases. Check them out and be ready for what is coming during the year. So what does the future, the immediate future, has for us Infinity fans, okay, regarding miniatures, okay, regarding monthly releases, okay? Let's show some previews. Zulu Cobra for Varuna Immediate Reaction Division, that lovely panel sectorial. Yeah, another Zulu Cobra, but this is a female Zulu Cobra, and this Zulu Cobra, sorry, I'm pronouncing in a very Spanish way, female Zulu Cobra, this is the hacker loadout, very important because this specialist, okay? So Zulu Cobra, coming to you for March, I guess, or maybe April, I don't know. Moving on, for the Invincible Army, another orange armor. This time is the Haida with the sniper rifle, which is the one that has multi-spectral visor level 2. Sniper rifle, okay. Very useful, very flexible unit, okay. For which army? I guess all the armies can benefit from this one. Box of Brawlers. Yes, Box of Brawlers. Many people was asking about this. Brawlers who can go with Beiran, with JSA, with Ikari, with many armies, okay. SWC Box of Brawlers, finally. Two male, two female, lovely box. Okay, with all the weaponry. Nice! Okay, what else? for Tunguska jurisdictional command. Yeah, Perseus, okay, Perseo. Perseus, Perseus, I don't know how to pronounce. The rock Myrmidon, okay, look at that. Look at that. It's a Myrmidon, but it's from the Nomads, okay? You will recognize the certain features of design from Nomads and also from Aleph. By the way, it's like the first Myrmidon made in 3D, you know. So you, we were talking about piecing Aleph from Nomads. Well, you have a totally N3 Myrmidon, and they do not. So, troll them, absolutely, maximum trolling, okay? Yeah, Tunguska, Nomads. Congratulations to you. Okay, now you have a Myrmidon. And finally, for the TAC, for the Russian army, okay, box, SWC box of Frontovix. Yes, Frontovix, the load. You already have one from the Beyond Call from box. Now you have the box of four with all the loadouts, and they're all manly and Russian and tough as nails. Lovely box. I love these guys. They look like soldiers, real soldiers, okay. This has been some of the previews that I have for you, and now let's go with your Q&A. So, Alberta, Canada, colder than carbonite, we have a Q&A section here, because Matt Shafi was kind enough to compile some questions from the fans, and we, Corpus Belli, are able to provide direct communication with you, okay? Happening to you. Okay, so let's go. Matt Shafi, there are a lot of internet-style rumors that describe the differences in between Spanish terrain setups and North American terrain setups. The theory being that the Spanish terrain is usually much more open than the North American, with longer lanes of fire and less cover. Do you see this as a reality? Has it ever been? I think that is correct. Every time I go to the USA, they check the tables, and they are lovely and dense and full of terrain, and everybody. That we, when we organize the interplanetary tournament here in Spain, I mean, it's not just my opinion. Many foreign players have seen that. I mean, when American players come to Spain, they see the tables and they think that they are more open. By the way, kudos to the Americans and Canadians guys who painted their terrain, because the display that I've seen and things like Rumble, when everybody brings a table and it's incredible, that is deserves all the respect in the world, really. So, yeah. Which is the most correct setup of terrain? Yeah, let me tell you. Is that another question by Machafi. Does Corbus Belli anticipate a decreasing market share in response to the recent glut of certain company brand skirmish games? This is a question about the industry of the war games and stuff like that. I can tell you that in 2017, Corvus Belli experienced an impact of another company making something huge and stuff like that. But we are still here. I mean, games have their moments, and the moments is usually the launch of that game. Everything goes like this. It will happen that Corvus Belli at some point has another big moment of impact, and another company will release stuff. I mean, what we know is that we have been doing this game since 2005, so we have survived through a lot of things, okay? Corvus Belli has this kind of resilient, okay, company, because we produce our own miniatures, so we can go through everything. It's a complex question, and I don't like to talk about other companies. It's like, you can be sure that we will be here in the years to come, because the way we do things, we can adapt, okay? And lately, our online store is working lovely, so get the stuff thrown on the store, yeah. Is there any timeline for when Sarsbasti are going to be updated? Anything that can be shared of the changes that might be coming? Yeah. There are three big moments of the Sarsbasti happening in 2019, okay? They are going to be the main villains, the main bad guys for all the plots, all the development of the timeline of the human sphere, okay? Because they are everywhere. They have been infiltrating the human sphere for years now. Another question. Any plans to do an O-12 themed non-aligned army? This is a question by Paul Soden. O-12 being a non-aligned army? No. I mean, no. Why making O-12 a non-aligned army? They are like the United Nations. they will be much better delivered to you as a faction with designs, with a big box, with lots of miniatures. I mean, something official, okay? Something more integrated with Aleph, in my opinion, because we know that O12 uses the Aleph remotes, for example, but not as an online army. If we do it, we have to do it correctly, you know? Keith Johnston, I have one question for the main man. Where are the Sasbasti? Oh, yeah. They are coming. Everybody's asking the same question. They are coming. In fact, let me tell you a little secret, a little insight. When Connie and myself were making the third offensive week here, right here, okay, we were going to make the Sasbasti video. We had the contents and we had some images and we were going to make the Sasbasti video. 2 days before making that video, they told us that no, they were delaying the Sasbastis. The Sasbastis were going to be the big thing for 2019 and it's going to come in the next book, not in third offensive. So suddenly, Connie and I were like, what do we do? So that is why we improvised that silly Morad video in the third offensive week. Go back to YouTube, check out the Morad video, the Combined Army video of the third offensive week, and you will see that we are just talking about the Morads, and the Morads are saying, where are the Sasbasti? That is why we made that video that way, because 2 days right before filming and the deadline was like there, suddenly we got out of contents. But don't worry, the Sasbastis will be great. I'm pretty sure of that, pretty confident of the potential of lovely miniatures that they're going to have. Are there any plans to move the Infinity Line to a pre-assembled plastic similar to Aristeia? not at all, not happening at all. If that is a rumor somewhere, kill it right now. Not happening, absolutely not. Not on my watch. Another question. Devin Ruth. Are there plans for any novels or short stories? Outrage was very enjoyable and it would be cool to get more stories with a narrative thread line. Yes, there is a new book coming, a book that is supposed to close the trilogy between Uprising, Third Offensive, and finally that book. That's a book that is supposed to unlock 5 new armies, okay? And apart from that, there's a new project for a manga happening, okay? The manga Outrage, made by Kenny Reed and Victor Santos, was one of the best things that Corvus Elec has ever produced, and we're pretty much willing to repeat the experience of making something lovely like that, okay? And that is fluff and narrative stuff. Victor Santos, he is the writer of Polar, which is a graphic novel that is having a movie right now, and he is writing, once again, the manga for Infinity. So yeah, big names. Moving on, when can we expect a cleanup of the rules? This is a question by Xenonberg. Definitely not during 2018. If we want to clean up, streamline the rules, that would mean a very, very ambitious project that has to be carried by smart people with a long period of development, and that cannot be a PDF file happening in a Tuesday. That has to be properly done, okay? Stephen Bosco asks, will there be an art book number 2? Was Panama a mistake? Definitely not during 2018 there will be an art book 2, but I'm glad that you asked because I think we have plenty of lovely artwork that will build a lovely art book 2, so ask for it. By the way, Pano was a mistake, is a mistake. They do not deserve to be number 1 because number 1 is the place for you, Ching. Moving on, Tyler Day. Just wondering, with all new sectorials getting wildcard and mixed links, mixed fire teams, I was wondering if CB has plans to go back and adjust all the sectorials. Yes, mixed sectorials is the way to go now, is the new flavor. Everybody likes the approach of the new release armies, and Corvus Belli wants you to focus on the new release armies. The old armies will get their little upgrades with time. Right now, what we want to do is everybody to focus and to jump on the train of Ramatas Force, of Varuna, of Invincibles, because those are the new miniatures that are coming, and that's why they are so great, okay? And at some point, if certain armies go down in the level of popularity, of participation and stuff, is when Corvus Belli decides, okay, this army needs an upgrade, and it's the moment now. But that has to... has the momentum, okay? Resculpts, upgrade of the rules, that has to come together in a very well-chosen moment. That makes much more sense for us to work like that, not okay, upgrade of the rules happening here, and now resculpting happening here. No, it's much better to make a super powerball, okay? Another question, Chris Wyman, any tidbits you can show for the Touha? And it is the last question. The Touha are going to have their moment in 2018. It's going to be a pretty intense moment. In fact, the next plot twist happening to the Infinity Timeline that is going to make the whole human sphere evolve, okay, is going to have the Touha right in the eye of the storm. And it's going to be huge, and it's going to be cosmical, it's going to blow your mind away, okay? Remember the Rising? Remember the Rising? That was nothing compared to what is going to happen into the human sphere in 2019. Like that. Now, here, this is the end of the Q&A section. Here's a preview of Patsy Garrett, the orc female Harris provider of the Varuna Immediate Reaction Force, okay? And here's an image of a new model for Nauf, the character from the manga, okay? That is for you. This has been the colder than carbonite, because right now I'm freezing, okay, here. This has been the Q&A section, the previews, the new releases, information, valuable information for the rest of the year, and this has been it, okay? You have been bostiais. This is the end. It was great to make this video for you. It's a great way to show support to the Satellite Tournament and have direct communication with the fans. We love that you play our game in Canada. I would love to visit Canada someday. Thank you so much. Bye.